In this video, we're looking at Keeper Security. I'm going to tell you what it does, why you should be using it, and then give you a brief rundown of how it works. Keeper Security is credential management software. That is, it stores your passwords and other secrets in an encrypted database. Using password management software like Keeper increases both your security and your convenience. On the security side, Keeper stores your credentials in an encrypted database that even Keeper themselves cannot read. This is much more secure than storing your passwords in Excel or Word or post-it notes on your desk. In addition, by remembering all your passwords, it allows you to set long, random passwords for your websites instead of short, insecure ones. It also allows you to set different passwords for each website and prevent password reuse, which is a big security risk. Finally, it can prevent phishing attacks because it will only fill in the password on the correct URL for that website. Storing your passwords in Keeper makes things much more convenient for you. No longer do you have to remember tens or even hundreds of passwords. No longer do you need to type those passwords tediously every time you log into a website. Keeper Security will sync your passwords across your multiple devices, including laptops, desktops, and your mobile. And you can even share credentials within your organization and control how they're accessed. Finally, you can store other important secrets, such as PIN codes or credit card details, within Keeper. To get started with Keeper, find the email you've received with the invite linked to create your account. Click on the link that says "Set up your account now." On the page that opens, your email should be pre-filled. If not, enter it here and then click Next. You'll now be asked to set your master password. Make sure that you set something that is as long and secure as possible while still being something you can remember and type regularly. Because of the way Keeper's encryption works, there is no password reset feature. Click to accept the Keeper Terms of Use and click Next. You're now presented with your new empty vault. Here you'll be prompted to perform some actions, such as importing passwords and creating your first record. I'm going to skip them here because I'm going to show them to you in a moment, but you can do them here if you like. One thing we absolutely do want to do with our account is enable multi-factor authentication. So click Enable Now, and then choose Google and Microsoft Authenticator, as this is much more secure than using text messages. If you don't already have a multi-factor authentication app on your phone, you'll need to download that now. I recommend Authy, but you can use Microsoft Authenticator or Google Authenticator or any of the other trusted apps available. With the Authenticator app installed and open on your phone, find the option to add a new account, scan the QR code, and then enter the verification code shown. Here you can set how often Keeper will prompt you for a multi-factor code. Every 30 days is probably a good balance between security and convenience. Make sure you take a copy of the backup codes shown by selecting them all, copying and pasting them into Word and printing them out, or taking a photo on your phone and storing it somewhere safe, just in case you lose access to your authenticator. Once you've completed initial setup, you'll be presented with your new empty secure vault. If you already have some passwords stored elsewhere, such as in your web browser or another password app, the first thing you should do is import those by clicking on your username at top right, then settings, then going to import. You can see here there are a lot of options for importing from various apps as well as directly from your browser. To import from your browser, follow the prompts to download the Keeper Import tool. As it's downloading, copy the code shown by clicking the button. Then install the Keeper Import app that is downloaded. And once it's installed, paste the code you copied earlier and click Import. Keeper will then show you the passwords it has found, and if everything looks okay, click Add to Keeper. Click OK again, close the settings window. you'll then see your vault with all the passwords from your web browser imported into it. Now we'll take a look at saving logins for passwords that haven't been imported. When you first go to a website that you haven't saved in Keeper, it will offer to create a login. That's handy for sites where you're signing up for a new account, but this time we'll close that and then go ahead and enter our details that we have stored in our heads or on our post-it note. Enter the full password, and when Keeper says, "Would you like to save this password?" say yes. You'll see a pop-up with all the details of the account. You can change the title to whatever you like. I like to keep them short and simple. You can check that all the details are correct, and then hit save. Next time you visit the website, you'll see that Keeper recognizes it and asks, "Would you like to log in?" Click yes, the username and password get filled, and you're signed in without typing a thing. You can also enter credentials into Keeper manually. Click on the Keeper icon and then choose Vault. When your vault loads, you'll see all your existing passwords. To add a new one, click Create New, then Record. You'll see there are various record types in the drop-down. Login is the most common one and is used for websites. Give the login a title and then click Next. Fill in the remaining information for that record as needed and then click Save. Be sure to enter the correct website address so that Keeper can identify it and auto-fill it for you in the web browser. Along with the other record types, you can also create folders to organize your records. Click Create New, then Folder, choose the location, give the folder a name and click Create. You'll now see the folder in your vault. To move existing records into a folder, simply drag and drop and click Move. When you create new records, they will automatically be created inside the folder that is currently selected. You can create as many folders as you like and even nest them under each other. There are various configuration options to change the way Keeper behaves in your web browser. To access these, click the Keeper icon and then click Settings. For example, to stop Keeper from automatically logging in as soon as you load a web page, turn the Auto Submit option off. This way, it will still fill the password for you, but you'll have to click the login button manually. You can also set some security related options here, such as whether Keeper logs out automatically after a period of time and whether it stays logged in when you close your browser and restart your computer. There's also a Keeper desktop app available, which is particularly handy if you're regularly logging into things that are not websites, such as remote desktop computers or other applications. Simply log in using the same email address, password, and multi-factor authentication method as you do in the web browser, and you'll see your vault. Team members within an organization can share folders of credentials with other users or groups. You can identify a shared folder by the different icon. Depending on the permission set by the person sharing the credentials, you may have permission to edit and read or just read, provided they contain a valid website address. Shared credentials will autofill in the web browser just like your normal ones do. If you have the correct permissions for that folder, you can also create new credentials within that folder so that all other members can see those credentials. To create a folder to share with other members of your team, click Create New and then Shared Folder. Choose where you'd like the folder to live within your folder structure, and then give the folder a name and click Create. Once the folder's created, you'll see it has the shared folder icon. Click Edit, then Users, then from the drop-down, add the team members that you would like to give access to. Set their permission level, and then click Save. Thank you for watching.